Morning. Bright and early, time to go to work. Got the extra special dog habitat set up here. And of course, if you're going to follow me today, it's going to be a constant this. Big production that happens on my YouTube channel here. Saturday morning, I'm filming me while being filmed. What are we doing? Hurry up, you're blocking the road.
Get out of the way.
First things I do when I get here is my full-time job, which is not driving the car, it's getting fuel ready. That's like what we do. And people ask all the time, why do the drivers mix the fuel? The long and the short of it is, the crew guys want us to do that so we stay out of their way. So that's kind of why. You know I'm full of stories, so this wooden box has, you can tell it's very old. It has a beaker in it that I mix fuel with. I've been using this wooden box. This is my 26 year in top fuel. And this box actually come from Tommy Johnson Sr. And I've used it my entire career. It's getting beat up and kind of tired, but one of my heroes was Ray Godman. He's in the Drag Racing Hall of Fame, had the Tennessee Bo Weevil cars, and he's a local guy to me. We miss him. So it's actually Homeland Security law, I guess, but we can only have 42 gallons of nitro in our pit area, so we don't keep enough for the entire weekend. But we can text Sunoco, and they'll just bring us our fuel when we need it, and that's what I'm doing. I'm ordering fuel. So every morning, it is load up. Kind of like what y'all have to do. Get your stuff ready. Load your SD cards and batteries and that sort of stuff. It's an everyday thing. But during COVID, I was bored. And if y'all go way back and look, you will see some awful YouTube videos during COVID of me and Donna doing some around home projects, and I got addicted to it. I just started doing it, and then when we got back racing, I just kept doing it, and thank goodness people are watching and it keeps growing. So last night before I went to bed, I kind of do this every weekend, I edit and I do all that on my phone, and then this morning before I really got up and going, sitting there drinking my coffee, I edited some more. Damn, so we're going to be shadowed all day, so we have to act right.
Oh, that's not good. I should probably leave right now.
You know that Cleavis guy? Yeah. How are y'all?
Good.
So, all right. Sign this for you.
All right.
Race cars today? Me too. Have fun, all right?
Yeah, you
going
to race too?
I am going to race. Be a little while, but I'm going to race. Thank you for coming.
Thank you so much.
See ya. The life of a YouTuber, we're now live with the trip coming here and our two qualifying runs from yesterday. So thumbnails made, put all the description stuff in, video's now live. And now we just hope people watch it, because YouTube, I can mess that up and really nobody's mad at me, but if I mess up over here, it might be a lot of people mad at me. Although some of you commenters You get mad at me, but that's okay. At least you're watching.
Can I get a picture?
Of course.
Thank you so much.
You
for
have
your time.
Fun today, okay?
Oh, yeah, y'all have fun.
All right. Let's
go.
Morning. We are headed to the Mission Foods autograph session for the Too Fast, Too Tasty Challenge, which we are a part of today. So qualifying is also racing today, which is kind of neat because it changes your mindset on qualifying because the wind light does matter. Most of the time in qualifying, we're just thinking about, you know, staging nice and shallow, making the best run you possibly can make. But today we got to do all that as well as turn wind light on because I haven't won one of these yet and I want to. I don't want to say it's cheating, but I get a jump so because I talk too much. Well, we're going to go up here on stage and ramble on about nitro racing with Alan Reinhart. He makes it really easy because he knows actually more about it than I do. I may ride in it and drive it, but the truth is, whatever you ask, I'm gonna make up some answer, whether it's right or wrong. It doesn't matter. But that's what we're doing, Nitro School. Most awesome thing.
That's my favorite shirt. Where are they selling them at?
Hot Rod Randy's.
Oh, okay.
All the way down there on the right.
Okay. Have to give.
And of course, you know, we give all my shirt money goes to animal rescue.
Okay.
Yep. Thank you so
yeah,
much.
Yeah, I had the Milliken no, pen, but
this is the hurry up and wait portion. Get all dressed and ready to go, and all we're doing. Waiting on an NHRA official roll by on a scooter and give us the let's go sign. So I don't know, I think we're third quad from the back and it is the Mission Food, so wind light counts. This is get antsy. I do anyway. I start to get antsy, like I'm ready, let's go. But it's part of it. Just hurry up and wait. So Timo will tell me if he thinks we can improve over the run we've already made last night. My gut tells me we can't, so we might focus a little bit more on trying to get the wind light, but you gotta do both because it's racing and qualifying at the same time. So kinda handle it with not a lot of different than a normal race day. So it's hard though, it's hard because if you weren't qualified, which we are, if you weren't qualified, do all you can do just to get in. But when you are qualified in the four wide format, you might be beating the car that's beside you and you're both smoking the tires. And in a normal qualifying run, you'd shut that off. But in the four wide, you might still beat somebody on the other side because you can't see all four cars because the wall's tall enough you can't see them. But it's all good. I love it all.
Little guy, what are you doing it now? Looking at the dragster he's got in his hand, and he had one eye looking.
Oh, look at that one.
Compared to the two, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It's pretty cool.
Mine's faster.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Whenever you're ready, Rep.
Oh, okay.
Well, at this point, I'm like, all right, do I need to start putting my helmet on or not? But I look up here. Looks like we still got to wait on Pro Stock Bike. Then we'll get a little track prep. And we're third quad. I guess third quad, third lane. And it's just kind of chill out time for a minute.
Don't feel it sometimes.
I'll bet I got you by 10 years.
58.
66. So 8 years.
Yep.
We're still anyway, here. We're both kicking.
We're still here.
I hurt all the time, but we're still kicking.
Still here. Thank you, sir.
Run hard, brother.
Yes, sir. I'm addicted.
I know you are.
I'm addicted to chapstick.
Us too.
They just saw from the outside.
Funny cars are cool.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So that, have you ever rode like an old Polaris Razor?
No.
No?
Yeah.
Or drove one?
Okay.
So the older ones, it would, you couldn't help but do that.
Yeah.
You had to either mash the gas or if you got your sisters in there, you're trying to take off easy and you're going burp, burp,
yep.
burp, burp. And it was like, same thing.
Yeah, it looked like I was driving a stick for the first time.
right.
Yeah. But so the reason, so I was trying to like just creep into it and just make a nice roll because like earlier in the year, I had to pedal it first round to get the win.
Yep.
Well, I'd come off of it and I would just go right to half throttle and then I'd roll off of it and then roll back in once the tire kind of hooked back in. Well, every time I would go to half throttle and then come back off, it would put a hole out like almost instantly. So I'm like, all right, if I can just roll into it real nice and keep all eight lit, well, it'll be a real good pedal job, you know? And that was the result.
Yeah.
I haven't seen the footage. Don't just admit something first.
Right.
Just like,
oh,
like,
you're you know.
Yeah.
Well, we didn't know when we were watching the interview. He told
meant to be that.
Yeah.
All right.
It was
good luck.
Bad.
Love you, brother.
So in case you're wondering, Kayla's a doctor, and she monitors me because she likes collecting data. Her and Dr. Derek Wilcox, they do that. They've been doing it for years. What's it all mean? No idea. But I like them. They're good kids. And they like data.
Justin Ashley, 044 off the starting line. It's going to be Justin Ashley with a 373.9 at 321 and Antron Brown.
What's up, brother?
Doing good.
Wet. All right. I think they hit the old shutoff button on me. Which typically means it's got a hole out. So, we're one car too far over, which means we're out. It's weird, I saw a wind light and I'm like, no freaking way, but I guess you can see the wind light on the other side of the racetrack.
Yeah,
lane one and lane three got wind lights, so I saw a wind light. And I'm like, no way Justin was so far out in front of us. But I thought maybe we were second, you know?
Hey, all the oil stayed in it.
Yep.
To start.
That's a good thing. Yeah. I did smell a little something, but...
I don't think it's too thrilled, but I mean, when it's hurting.
The real question is, though, was that number eight?
I don't know.
I hope not.
I noticed it was choo-choo pretty good on the one.
I ain't gonna lie to you, I was watching Justin Ashley.
Okay.
That's the trip.
Yeah.
I was looking over at him. Was it ripping? No.
No.
I was watching him. So I was not looking forward. It's all good. It's like a buyback at a bracket race.
I don't think there's a car here that can't run middle 70s.
Yeah.
Gotta get my lipstick on. That chapstick. Ain't chapstick, Burt's beeswax. But I'm addicted to it. There are worse things to be addicted to. I think it's partly from talking too much. I felt more confident about it about 30 minutes ago. It's still a little bit of clouds, but it's not cool like it felt earlier. But I do think Jimbo's going to try to get after it. I overheard him and Nikki saying they thought there's probably some high 60s out there. So, we'll see. not my decision, that's for sure. If I was a crew chief, we would smoke the tires a lot. Another thing with the 4-wide, it throws off your normal routine as to when to get ready. My typical routine is 4 pair back, start getting ready. But this goes so fast, I don't have a routine for when to get ready. So you'll see me always looking around. I'm people watching, but I'm also looking to see who's getting ready. Them 60s I was talking about, not so much when that sun's out like that. We need that cloud cover.
Best ET of the quad, Clay Milligan, lane number 4, 371.5 to 330 miles an hour.
Not too bad, right? 71. I told you there were some 60s out there.
I love my job.
Hey, it likes being turned up.
I keep telling him this thing likes being hit in the butt.
Man, 2 cents one day?
No! Eat again.
Eat again.
All right.
What up, bro?
Ready when you are.
What'd you say was 60 what?
24,
68.
15. 68,
yeah.
Good.
Still not average, but we're getting there.
You're right there in the wheelhouse.
Man. Yeah. Yeah, that's where we like you.
That's my papa, and guess what?
Somebody, I think, had a black cat cross their path and something. We're going to take the mirror thing out of that equation because we broke one right in the motorhome.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, Iggy did, though.
Yeah. Okay.
Actually, I don't know if it was Iggy or Millie. One of the two of them.
They'll never tell.
A combination of the two of them broke Lee's mirror.
Lee didn't want to touch it. I mean, she was like, I'm not touching it. Nope.
Until it was time to get ready
this morning.
Or yesterday morning. She has got this whole freaking setup that's ridiculous. It's funny.
Lee, it really is. I've heard about it from a couple people.
It's funny. So we're talking about my sister Lee. Do not take her on Let's Make a Deal. Because if you need it, she's got it. Most people that are watching this, no clue what is Let's Make a Deal or Monty Hall. My little sister Lee,
halt.
4 days, her bag
exceeded 50 pounds by a lot. Her backpack, she needs a two-wheel dolly to move it around.
And there she is.
Yeah, and there she is. Waiting on her YouTube content. She does have good YouTube channel.
I thought it was a what?
73.
Oh, so you was like kicking rocks up there?
Oh, actually went 70 with a one. So he got around.
Dude, still picked up a little.
We're four. Yeah, we're four.
Nice.
What was, Antron was ahead of us.
So yes, we use the NHRA a lot.
Somebody had a boomer out there. Yeah, somebody had a boomer. So Kurt kept asking me, what are we going to do? And I said, well, we're going to go 60-something, and then at some point at the stage away, I'm like, we're not going to go 60-something. I know you had to be like, holy crap, because it got hot, sun come out, and then clouds again. And
Antron didn't make it, so. Yeah, the temperature was, like, when we left the trailer, it was 80 degrees.
Yep.
And then when we ran, I think it was down to 75.
So we dropped 5.
Yeah, and then the track temperature, last
time
they
looked,
it was like 103,
so
pretty good.
Yeah. It felt really good. But when I was putting my fire suit on it, I heard y'all say it was 95. Like 30, 40 minutes before we left.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, and then it went up to like 106, and then once the black clouds came in, then it kind of like just stabilized.
Good run. It did not curb plump, but it hit it pretty good. Nick, you know what I was being on the,
yeah,
I remember telling you about the body pedal sound?
Yeah.
It gave me the body pedal sound.
It's still slow at half track, but these discs, like, they're not, and they might just not have enough ass for what compared to what we have. Yeah. We have the ones in investment, yeah, and even gains. So.
And it was fairly far down when it, I don't want to call it, it's not a curb plump, but the body panel pulled, yeah, though it gave me a little kick. Not a big kick at all, but a little kick. Alright, we gotta let him go to work.
Got a little feel.
For me, I've made so many rides down the racetrack. I love this. These are young folks. Don't get me wrong, I love stomping a lot, though. But when I come back and we've made a good run and they're excited like that and buzzing around, even though we ain't got to run until 12 o'clock tomorrow, just makes me feel good. Actually prideful as well, because you get so attached to these people. I'm very fortunate my family comes with me a lot, Tracy and Lee. Y'all have seen on here. These are my kids. I call them kids all the time. Sometimes they get frustrated. They're like, we're not kids. They're kids.
Well, having the driver aspect of it was what really drew it to us, right? So we were willing to take on all the learning curve. I didn't want to have to develop a driver. And from the marketing side, it was no-brainer, right? He's one of the favorites and does such a great job and his passion. We're continuing to learn. I've always loved field racing. I grew up in California as a kid going to all the big field races on the West Coast, Irwindale and Orange County and Carlsbad and Lyons. And it's very addicting. And so it took a while for me to figure out how to monetize it from a business standpoint. And I think we've figured out most of that now. But it still is a learning curve, and it's, nothing comes easy. So that's kind of what we like about it. And I'm not willing to give up, and we're willing to work hard.
And for me, one of my favorite things, besides just, I truly do love Rick Ware, and I'm not just saying that. Me and him have become super close. But when he started this whole thing, he's like, man, if we could win a race, my goals would have been met. And we won one sooner than probably he ever thought, and then to do it three times last year was
Actually, that exceeded my expectations. I was hoping to win a couple last year, and then when we won big.
Yes, we did. It was awesome. And, you know, it's just, you know, and winning's addicting too, right? So, but you know, it's a fickle sport, and you got to service these cars, you got to service the parts, and it's everybody here has good stuff, and so it's a great challenge, right? Keeps you on your toes. But I love the fact that we can put together a team of people and funding to be competitive for race wins. That's what's important from the business standpoint. I love growing the sponsors and getting them involved in other races. It helps us grow our footprint and it makes us stronger in the motorsports industry. But there's just nothing like nitro methane. I don't know what else you can say.
That's a fact.
Once you've been here, and so I get to bring a lot of people from different motorsports to their first field race. And I get a kick out of it just because I know what's going to happen. And I remember it as a kid going to see the funny car shows and stuff. Nobody, I don't care what kind of experience you have in other motorsports, you know, you say it's loud, you say it's fast. I mean, what does that even mean? Until you're there and you're gasping for air and your eyes are burning and, you know, you got, you know, the Richter scale's going off and you're going 300 miles an hour in a couple seconds. So it's just great. And once we bring them, man, they're hooked. The fans for life. So it's great. I'm just thankful to have the sponsorship, the people. I'm just thankful to have Clay be part of it. Him and his family are fantastic. And, we love these guys.
You know, it actually went really good. We have, there's no secret. We struggled the first part of the year taking out the test session where we were rolling. We blew the thing up several times, I mean big ones, and Jimbo and Nikki kind of backed up and basically it was a reset, I would call it. They kind of did a reset and started getting ready to baby step. Where were we at? Las Vegas? Vegas went pretty good. No real blow-ups. It's not unusual for these things to hurt stuff, but we've had major like blower off the car, injectors gone, wiped out all kinds of stuff. So I feel like the car's getting back under us the way it was in the middle part of the year last year, and that's coming at a good time because our next race is Chicago, and going back to last year, we're the defending champion there. And to further that story a little bit, we were struggling last year at this point badly. I think we qualified number 15 in Chicago, but once Jimbo kind of got a hold of it, we were off and running. And we've got Nikki here now, and he's a huge asset to Jimbo because it takes a lot to run these teams. I mean, we had Bruce Reed with us for a huge part of the year last year. Bruce Reed is part of the royal family from Australia in the top fuel world, but we can't have him all the time. So getting Nikki was huge for this team. And I think once they kind of really get this thing up under them, this game on and wind lights on coming, I believe that. So our goal is always obviously to win, but the main goal is for everybody to do the best job they can do. If the driver goes out there and has a pretty good light and the car runs a pretty good number and you don't get a wind light, you did the best you could do. Are you happy about it? Absolutely not. You know, but what that does is kind of set a benchmark that, you know, I didn't make a mistake, but I need to do better. And that's something that everybody on a race car needs to do all the time, actually in life, to be honest with you. You always need to strive to do a little better than what you're currently doing. And so the goal tomorrow, obviously, is three wind lights. I've been in a lot of finals at the four wides. I haven't won one yet. But more importantly, we just need to progress with the car, the driver, and make sure everybody's safe and get ready for race day and then get ready for the next race.